Hello friends, welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to work a basic chevron stitch. Now in this pattern, as you can see, the zigzags that are getting formed are mainly because of the increases as well as the decreases or the reductions that we are providing at these points. This is a very easy stitch and two most important things that you should remember when working a chevron stitch is that first, the stitch is a multiple of 11 plus you need to work 4 more stitches. Another thing is that while working a chevron stitch, you should go for 2 or 3 color variations, because when you work these patterns using 2 or 3 different colors, the zigzag design will be very prominently visible and that will give a lovely look to your crochet work. Moreover, these patterns can be used for working baby blankets as well as baby skirts, even shawls. Now let's see how this pattern is worked out. For this, I have taken a 3.5 mm crochet hook, two different colors and a pair of scissors. The first two rows I'll be doing with this light pink colored yarn. Now as I mentioned earlier, the stitch should be a multiple of 11 plus 4 stitches. So I'm going to work 26 stitches. So that will be the second multiple of 11 plus 4 stitches. So here I worked about 26 chains. Now I'll be skipping the first 3 chains and working 2 double crochets into the 4th chain. Now into the next 4 chains I'll be working 1 double crochet each. Now in order to get this depression over here, what I'll be doing is I'll be skipping the next 2 chains and working 1 double crochet into the 3rd chain. So I'm going to skip the first and the second chain and working a double crochet into the 3rd chain. Again I'll be working in total 4 double crochets. So I've already done with one of the double crochets. Now into remaining 3 stitches I'll be working 1 double crochet each. So in total I have worked 4 double crochets. Now in order to get this raise or a peak kind of thing that we have over here, I'll be working increases, that is 3 double crochets into the next stitch. Now once this is done, again it will be followed by 4 double crochets, 1 double crochet per stitch. So into next 4 chains, I'll be working 1 double crochet each. So now the stitch is a repeat sequence. Now as I had done earlier, 4 double crochets followed by skipping 2 chains and working again 4 double crochets. Then into a single stitch, I need to work 3 double crochets. So it will just repeat like this till the end of the row. I need to skip the next 2 stitches and work a double crochet into the 3rd stitch. I need to work total 4. So I'm left with my last stitch. Into this stitch I'll be working 2 2 double crochets to end the row. So this finishes my first row. Now as per this pattern, I'll be working 2 rows with the same color. After this is done, I'll change the color and work the remaining rows in the similar way. So for the second row, I need to chain 2 and turn my work, and into the same stitch, that is the first double crochet, I need to work 2 more double crochet stitches. Now into the next 4 double crochets, I'll be working 1 double crochet each. Now we have come to the point where we had created this depression kind of thing. Again, we need to skip the next 2. As we had done for the first row, we had skipped the 2 chains. Now we have to skip the next 2 double crochets and work a double crochet into the third stitch. Again, I'll be working 4 double crochets in total. And into the next stitch. Exactly speaking, this will be the middle double crochet of the 3 double crochets we had worked earlier into a single stitch. So onto the top of the middle double crochet, we'll be working 3 double crochets. Again, the pattern is the same. You'll be continuing with 4 double crochets into the 4 stitches. And over here, I'll be skipping the next 2 double crochets, making a double crochet into the third stitch. So I'll be finishing with the last 4 double crochets of this round. And into my last stitch, I'll be working 2 double crochets. Now from here on, you have to repeat the row 2 either with the same color, or if you are changing the colors, then you need to change the color, but the sequence remains the same. So I'll just cut off my yarn over here and join my new yarn. I'm joining the yarn to same place where I cut my yarn. I need to chain 2. Now into the same place, that is the last double crochet of the previous row, I need to work 2 more double crochets. So the sequence is same as I done in my second row. I need to just keep this tail under my stitch so that it gets hidden. Now into the next 4 stitches, I'll be working 4 double crochets. So I've done my 4 double crochets. Now again, we have to repeat the sequence of skipping the next 2 and working a double crochet into the third stitch. So I hope this pattern is getting very clear to you. It's just a repeat of the second row all the way around, just by changing colors. as you wish. Either you can change the colors after every second row or change color alternately, that is after every row is done. Moreover, if you wish to make any multicolored blankets, then this pattern will look very attractive when you change color after every row. So it all depends upon your own creativity and choice. So here I've done with my 4 double crochets. Again, I need to increase into the middle double crochet of the 3 double crochets that I worked in my previous row. Again, I'll be repeating of the sequence by making 4 double crochet into next 4 stitches. And then skip the next 2 double crochets and work a double crochet into the 3rd stitch. Followed by 3 more double crochets. And into my last stitch, I am working 2 double crochets to end the row. So you can see how this zigzag shape is getting formed. So I'll be working one more row with this same color, and then after that I'll be changing color to the previous one, that is the light pink color, and continuing with the sequence. So just you have to repeat the row 2 as I had mentioned earlier for n number of rows that you'll be making. So once I'm done with my second row with this color, I'll show you how this pattern looks. So I've done 2 rows with this color. So this pattern is getting very prominently visible. Here you can observe that on the top of the depressions that we have done, it is always a depression, and on top of the raises or the peaks of the zigzag pattern, it's always a raise or a peak. So that's all for today's tutorial. If you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.